Hello guys, welcome back to Net Plus Training Channel. In today's video, we'll be diving into how you can create a sleek, professional looking email signature using Google Docs. Now let's get started. Now let's go to Google Docs. You can get to Google Docs from inside your Google Drive account. Open drive.google.com and click New. And from the drop-down, select Google Docs. This will create a new Google Docs document in another tab. Or you can go directly to docs.google.com/documents to create a new Google Docs document. Click here to name your document. Now, we are going to start off by creating a table. You want to create a two-column document table. One column for the profile image and the second column from the signature text details. So go to Insert in the top toolbar and then Table. Create a 2x1 table. Now reduce the size of the left side box by dragging this line in the middle to the left, making sure there is enough room to place your logo or image. On the right side, we are going to add the signature content. On the left box, you can choose to add a business logo or your profile image. This signature is for my personal email account. So I'm going to add my profile photo. I use Photoshop to create a circular image. You can use Canva to do the same. You can also add a rectangular or square image if you want. The best profile photo is between 120 by 120 to 150 by 150 pixels. This is my own profile photo. To add the image, click on the left side box. Then go to Insert in the top toolbar, then Image, and then click any of these options to upload your image or company logo. You can upload from your computer, from Google Drive, Google Photos, or if you already have the URL of the image, you can select the web address option. I'm going to select an image from my computer. This places your profile image or brand logo in this box. You can adjust the size of the image by clicking on the image and then dragging one of the corners. You can also adjust the width of the box accordingly. Now let's add the signature details. Click inside the right side box. Here we are going to add some details, including important links you'd like people to browse through. I'm going to add my name, job title, and company name. I'm going to add a horizontal line to separate the name from the other details. To add a line, go to Insert, and then click horizontal line. Then below the line, we are going to add our contact information, like phone number, website address, email address, and business address. You can format it. You can change the font if you want, but don't use any fancy fonts. Just stick to the default font, as many people will see it in the standard email font anyway. Reduce or increase the size. You can bold, italicize, adjust the spacing. Add color to font. Select the web link and then add a link by clicking the link button on the top menu and then insert the destination link. Do so for the email and so on. Then below that, let's add social media icons. For social media icons, you can get them for free off any free icon website like flighticon.com or Icon Finder or Icon Scout. Or you can just Google for social media icons and click on this website. We have lots of icons you can get for free. Click on this one and then select the smallest size. I'm going to select PNG image option. Click download to download it to your computer. Do so for other social media icons you want to add. Then go back to Google Docs. To upload the image, go to Insert, Image, and then upload the images from your computer. After upload, adjust the size. Click on the image, then right click and select image options. Go to size and rotation and reduce the size to fit. Click on the others and do the same. Another way to add social media icons is to use Google Docs add-ons. You can add any social media icons extension from Google Workspace. To do that, at the top of Google Docs, go to Extensions and then Add-ons. then get Addons. It will open Google Workspace Marketplace. In the search bar, enter icon and select any of the free icons extensions. I like the Icon Scout extension. Select that and click install. Select your email, then click continue to sign in. Give it access to your account and click allow. Click done and then close. Now, if you go back to extensions, you will see the add-on. To add social media image, click on the extension and then click search. It might ask you to create an account and log in. Click on the sign up button and this will take you to the Icon Scout website. Sign up with any of your Gmail addresses and then click this button and this will grant you access to the add-on icons and tools inside Google Docs. Go back. On the right, select icons and then search for any icons you want. Select anyone you want, click on it and it's added. To reduce the size of the image, right click, image options, and reduce the size to fit. You can do so for any other social media icons you want to add. Also, in place of these words like phone or website, you can also use icons. For example, instead of this phone, I can use phone icon. So I'm going to click on it and delete. And then go up, click extensions, and then add on, and I'm going to search. Let's enter phone in the search, and then select the icon that you like, and then it will be added. Now I'm going to reduce the size and make that 0.3, and you can see it looks good, and you can do so for the others like web, email, YouTube, and so on. You can also link the social media icons directly to your social media by clicking on the icon, then click the link button at the top menu, and then insert the social media link. You can also do so for the rest. Now to finish, you can shorten the table at the end so that it's not too wide. Now we are done with this signature. Now to use this, we need to remove the table. To do this, we need to find the table properties. You can find the table properties by clicking on this small icon on the right side of the table and at the top select table options. If you don't see the table options, click anywhere inside the table and click on these three dots and then select table options. This will show you the table properties. In the table properties, you can adjust the padding, then go to color and now set the table border to 0. This will make the table disappear. Once done, select the entire signature with your mouse cursor and Ctrl+C or Command+C to copy. Now you can go ahead and paste the signature into any of your email services signature settings. You can use it in Gmail, Yahoo, Outlook, Apple Mail, or any other free email services platforms. For Gmail, go to gmail.google.com, click on the gear icon, and then in the quick settings panel, click See All Settings to open Gmail settings. In the General tab, scroll down until you see the Signature section and then give your signature a name. Now click Create. On the right in the Gmail Signature Editor, paste the design you created in Google Docs. Under the Signature Editor, select the email you want to add the signature to. Then for new email use, select the name of the signature you just created. For reply and forward, I'm going to select No Signature because I want the signature to only appear for new messages. Once satisfied, scroll down and click Save Changes at the bottom of the page. And there you have it, a professional looking email signature crafted entirely in Google Docs. Now every time you compose a new message, your professional looking email will automatically include the signature. The signature can be updated to promote any offers you want, or you can add any contact information you want people to see. Google Docs is also free, so you can easily update your signature at any time and update the signature in your Gmail settings. So if you have any questions or need further assistance, drop a comment below and I'll be happy to help out.
Click to watch other related videos below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.